Bricks and Minifigs is your one-stop shop for all things Lego. Hit the link below to find a store near you.
Hey everyone, Joshua Hanlon here, and today I'm in the Lego archive in Billund, Denmark. This is the working archive where they have every Lego set ever made going all the way back to 1958. As we walk over here, you can start to see the very beginning of their displays. Now, if you've seen our past archive videos from a few years ago, this space looks very new and different. They've moved it about 6 months ago, so it's much more open. You get a lot more light in here, and then they've also added to the collection, so it goes all the way back to the very beginning in 1958 with these original Lego system sets. This is a working archive, so that you are allowed to open boxes, you're allowed to look at the pieces, because there are other archives where they preserve them as well. So you can see these very early parts with some of those early trees there that don't even really look like a Lego piece today, but then of course the 2x4 bricks in there are very recognizably Lego. So that's the late 50s, and as we move down here, you go pretty quickly through the years. You'll notice these first couple rows cover about 20 to 25 years worth of time because you just didn't have the volume of sets coming out that you do today. You start to see some of the Lego system branding here. I love this ship here and the way that the back of it opened up there. You got those early blue rail track pieces. You can see some more with that blue rail with the trains down there. And then fantastic stuff all around here. As we go on to this next section, on this side, you get into the late 1960s and a lot more of that blue track, sort of the early houses and city sets as well. Here's some really fun kind of house building with the green shutters there. You see the shell, which is something that Lego's done a lot with over the decades. And then as we turn around to this side, you get into the 1970s. And this is where you see kind of more versions with kind of more boat holes here. And some of these even smaller sets like this, some of these things you'll see on display at kind of Lego conventions, and people will have collected this and brought it out to a show to display, which is always really cool. And then these ducks, which you actually see kind of versions of that around Legoland or Lego and Billund. Of course, you have the Yellow Castle here, 1978. So they've got the iconic sets. You can open this up. You can see inside there. If you've never seen just like a sealed Yellow Castle set, this is amazing to see. I love this USS Constellation set. It's always been one of my favorite sets to see when going through the archive. Then you start to see some Duplo type builds here, and you get the younger kids involved. So that's 1977. Then in the late 70s, you start to get classic space. Here's set number 920, the rocket base, and then you start the Technic as well. So tons really great Technic stuff with those old classic Technic tires. Fabuland, always one of my favorite themes to point out just because it's so unique and so different and very unusual. Here's some more. This is like kind of a modern castle town, so something like you might see in a number of different places in Europe. You would see places like this. And that's from 1980. And then even more Technic here, more of this Fabuland. So you open that up and see the crazy Fabuland characters. And then we'll round the corner here. A couple of other excellent content creators in here as well right now pointing out some sets. So I wanted to point out this one here from 1984, another great castle set. So some of these are kind of the earlier iconic sets here with the big gray castle. I love the flip-up lids, which are always amazing to be able to see inside there. That's always super fun. We'll move around these
Duplo,
guys here. Yes, Duplo. Always got to talk about Duplo more. Some of the things in the archive are just really unusual. Like this here, this is the Lego TC logo. So I'm not even entirely sure what this set is, but you can see it here. It looks like they maybe spin around on a system there, almost like a Lego education product. So they've released so much stuff over the years, and that's the fun of kind of going through the archive. This is from 1987. You get to see a great variety of a lot of this stuff. And then even the branding on some of these things, like this here, you can see all different languages and markets that they've released stuff in. you start to see the different products and the way that they've done that over the years. In 1986 there, and then come down here, here's the basic building set. So this is just kind of a collection of parts you can kind of do whatever you wanted with. You get some of the bigger Technic cars. This one here is from 1988. And let's see, big Blacktron, I believe this is, with the yellow and black. Look at inside there with all those pieces. Look at how happy that kid is. This is so much fun here. One of my favorite themes is the Forest Men, and you've got a few of those sets right here. These always had so many fun play features. I'll pull this out here. And look, the prime condition minifigures, and just kind of reenacting all your Robin Hood stories there. It was always so much fun. Over here, we start to get into the early 90s, so we moved through a lot of that section pretty quickly. You, of course, have the massive 1989 Black Seas Barracuda. Look at this, incredible. This one actually, I think the flap has already come off on this, but you've got all of this inside here, the famous Lego pirate captain that's now a oh, and look at what has just been delivered to me, my favorite set of all time. Wow, thank you, sir.
Goodbye.
We'll come to that in a bit. It's good to know that they've got it well preserved here. But yeah, so for many Lego pirate fans, that's one of their must-have sets. And then here is 6276. This is from 1989. Another fantastic Imperial set here. So the Imperial and Pirates were just incredible themes for me growing up, you know, buying some of those older sets, playing with them as a kid. I love to see this. And more pirate sets there as well. Then you get some of the fantastic castle. Castle and pirates were some of my favorite themes, so I wanted to point those out with the ghosts and some of these great pieces and sets that we had here, especially again like this Forestman set as well. But I don't want to ignore some of the other fandoms like M-tron here. So I know for space fans, M-tron was a theme that a lot of people love, and you've seen some great M-tron builds at Lego shows that we've covered over the years. Shout out to this kid's yellow-orange combo there in that lifestyle photo. Fantastic work. And as we make our way down, there's lots of Duplo here as well. So, and of course, we got to mention some monorail. Lego fans love to talk about monorail and always wanting monorail to come back. This is the airport shuttle set. Look at those fantastic-looking monorail tracks inside there. I love it. All those great minifigures. More pirates. I think this is some Paradisa from 1992. A rather bizarre theme with some incredible pastel colors. Super, super unique here. Maybe with the Barbie movie coming out, we'll see a bit of a resurgence in that theme. Who knows? Another fantastic large pirate ship. Lots of great Technic sets here. I'm not sure what's happened with this clown figure on the side of this Duplo box. That's a little strange. Large castle, a big build-up base plate, and look at the decorations on the knights there are just amazing. So much good stuff. And you even got the little wolf pack figure as well. We'll keep moving through because we want to show you kind of as much as possible. It's easy to spend hours and hours and hours in here. But this takes us into the mid-90s now, and check out this unique little Lego System Pirate set. So it's in like a treasure chest. I love that. I love some unique Lego packaging. That's always super fun. Got the freestyle here. You can see just kind of like build whatever you want. Then here's some train / town. City stuff, we're in 1995 now. Feel free to comment on the video with your favorite year or some of your favorite sets maybe that you've spotted here. We start to get into Western, but first we gotta give a shout out to Time Cruisers. This is a really different theme from 1996, and you just see like craziness going on here with all sorts of pieces used. So always fun to see this as well. Then of course we get into my favorite Lego theme of all time, the Western sets. And here you can see the gold mine set. Pieces still sealed, looking in pristine, beautiful condition. Absolutely wonderful. This is from 1996. I love this large Technic space shuttle, also from 1996. We've had so many incredible space builds, but some of these early ones, still very impressive. That back in there. Here's, again, some unique base plates. It's cool to see. This is like a free Aqua Playscape, so it's like kind of the marketing idea there. Then you had Scala, which was also very unique. I think this is, I haven't seen this before. This is like a Scala base plate that you could build up on and create kind of your own almost Barbie-style world. And all of these different Scala, very large like dollhouse type sets there. And then over here we have more Western sets. This one is fantastic. This is 1997 now. You get the Native American village. Put this back in here. Oh, I like this one with the packaging. So you can kind of create your own sort of Monument Valley type scene in there. Lego Island, fantastic game. And some great road plates there to create your own Lego Island city. And I mentioned Scala. These sets are absolutely huge here, these massive Scala sets. This is pretty funny, actually. So this theme lasted for a few years. We're in 1998 with these large dollhouse scale builds. Snap, which is a very different theme as well. I think this is kind of the precursor to some of what we saw with Bionicle and some of those other construction type themes. You got more Technic sets there. Here's lots of the Lego games, like chess, favorite childhood one there. You can see the CD case is there as well. Oh, and we get into the early Ninja, which I love here. So before Ninjago in the late 90s, 1998, we had this Ninja theme, which aimed to be a little more realistic to kind of Japanese architecture. Super fun. And the early Adventures, Johnny Thunder sets as well, exploring Egypt, going around the world on all sorts of incredible adventures. I like this little fun Duplo figure there as well. We got early Mindstorms in 1998. This is when you just started to see some of the robotic stuff start to come out. And nowadays, of course, you've got First Lego League and all of these incredible robotics organizations. But back then, that was all just kind of starting up. We'll head over into the very late 90s here now as well. And you start to see more Duplo, Jack Stone, which of course, not sorry, many people's favorite thing. But we, do you need to point out your favorite one set? Question, yeah.
We've seen this at Brickboard, like on the GBC thing, right?
Oh yes, yeah, using the track for like a GBC module. Yeah. Is that yes, right? Very good. Yeah,
just
very good
ahead.
Job.
I'm sorry, okay. Really sorry.
No, that was
Jack
worth.
Stone, very
yeah,
very
Jack Stone, iconic. Okay, iconic. And then Lego Studios, so this was, you can see Jurassic Park kind of branding there, but this was like the movie shooting kind of type Lego theme, which you see this Lego and Steven Spielberg Movie Maker set. Had the camera, very cool stuff. And you get into 2000 here, so you start to see some of the early Star Wars. Several years ago, we actually made a video in the old archive going through every single Lego Star Wars set, and so we'll make sure to link to that in the description where you can see all of the different Star Wars sets that are in the archive if you want to check that out. Here is one of the large castle sets I had as a kid, which is a super fun set. This is from 2000, and again, that raised base plate, you get the bull knights there attacking the lion knight's castle. It's cool to see these very large scale Duplo sets with like the trains and things. Once again, you have more Scala, so that theme continues to pop up here and there. Here's one of the 2000 minifigure set. So this is like black and white packaging that they did around that time with some of those sets. Here's the huge Statue of Liberty, also from them back then, almost like just a regular cardboard box packaging. You've got Technic with kind of like Bionicle style canisters. And more Mindstorms, large trains here. So, fantastic passenger line train. You get the Pod Race, early 1999 Pod Race. This is actually the 1999 section right here. So this is all of the early Star Wars stuff when they first started out. There's the TIE Fighter and Y-Wing. So much incredible LEGO history here. I love this Adventurer's blimp. And you can see it kind of stuck out of the box here, which I think because of that, a lot of these got damaged in shipping. So not a ton of those survive, but really fun there as well. Let's come across here. Let's see, I think you come down here for kind of finishing out 2001. And I know Andreas showed us this earlier, but I gotta give it a shout out whenever I see this, because this is my favorite set of all time. This is Fort Legorado, the Western set, and tons of hours of playing this, so incredible. Can't say enough good about this set. It's really, really amazing. More Jack Stone here. So I actually did have a lot of this as a kid, even though I know a lot of people aren't a big fan. You start to see Harry Potter appear in 2001. And get the flip-up lid. I like how they kind of give you a bit of a teaser there, the packaging. You also start to see the appearance of Bionicle. And so this is like a Bionicle sort of board game right there. And then you start to see some of the early Bionicle canisters and characters popping up here as well. More fantastic pirate sets. I love it. You've still got Captain Redbeard making an appearance. And then this black and white legend packaging here. Get this one back in there. Large Yoda sculptures and big Star Wars sets down here, like the Star Destroyer. And of course, this bad boy. We can't forget about Galador. And the TDN module. I mean, just the meanest ship in the galaxy right there. See that thing flying through space. Always got to give a shout out to Galador here. There you go, Nick Bluetooth. Fantastic stuff. And then you've got Alpha Team, another kind of early 2000s, 2002 theme. It's really fantastic. See more of the bigger Bionicle. This is one of the board games here, so they really did a lot of different marketing for that. We'll move on into the next years now, 2003. Now you can start to see, as we get into the early 2000s, is when you start to see a tremendous amount of sets here. And so every row now is just kind of 1 or 2 years. There's so much going on here. More Bionicle and Star Wars. Really big. Larger scale sets like the Millennium Falcon. Here you start to see some of Spider-Man 2, some of the Spider-Man and Marvel movie stuff. Knight's Kingdom, another Knight's theme that I had a lot as a kid, but I know isn't everyone's favorite Knight's theme, but it's super fun. Some more of your Spider-Man 2, classic Spider-Man sets. At early advent calendar, this one's actually still sealed in the packaging, which is pretty cool, but throwback to a lot of those old brick-built characters. And Bob the Builder, you know, Duplo, they had all of the different licenses represented there. This one here, I think, can actually float. And some more Harry Potter here. This is from 2005 now that we're getting into. This set here is very unique. This is factory. So this was sort of like, you know, fan-built designs, and I think there's even, yeah, you see some of the fans on the back here that have worked on these. So this was, in a way, kind of Lego ideas, kind of getting some of those early fan designs represented there. Over here, we're still in 2005, massive Duplo castle, more Bionicle. This is, again, more factory here, so different, very different theme. So micro-scale kind of skyscrapers, large-scale Star Wars. You get to see some of the sports here, which is really cool as well. Soccer stuff, and I know they did basketball and hockey and a number of different factors. Look, it even has this nice carrying handle. The big dino sets, before we had all of these Jurassic Park sets, you had Dino 2010. Yeah, I remember this big helicopter was super cool, and then the light up lies or eyes on the dino. I love this big, just like tub of bricks from, this is 2006. You can see it's just tons of bricks, and I know that's what a lot of parents especially are like, that's what I just want to give my kids. So it's great to see when Lego releases stuff like that. The Boeing 787. This build looks great on display as well. Shout out to ExoForce, another one of my favorite themes when I was younger. Just super cool storyline. You had the kind of the whole comics idea going on there, and then lots of great characters. So we'll round the corner into the next decade. Still hard at work here, checking out all the best stuff. Oh yeah. Early Eiffel Tower. So of course we've had the new massive Eiffel Tower. I think it really kind of outshines this one in most ways, but it's always interesting to see the predecessors to the large scale sets of what we have today. Lego's done many underwater themes over the years. Here's Aqua Raiders. And this was one that I had. So a lot of these years were when I was kind of in my prime collecting Lego. This set, this Mars mission theme was super fun with the tubes. Again, kind of a version of a set they'd done in the early 90s or late 90s. More modular, 2007. The modular buildings start here, and that's always really amazing because that's when Lego really kind of pushed into more of the adult audience. Of course, you have Indiana Jones, which has made a recent resurgence, but these early Indiana Jones sets were super fun and brought us lots of great characters. Had your Knights theme. No, the boxes no longer have the flip-up lid here, so not as fun on the packaging in my opinion, but nice. Castle, you also have the early Batman sets here as well from 2008. There's like a few year run there. Again, 2008 modular building, the Green Grocer. Start to see more Bionicle canisters as that theme evolved over the years. And then your large scale limited edition Twilight build. Star Wars sets from 2008. Lots of great city sets. This one here is the town plan, which is a throwback to 1958. So you saw at the very beginning of this video, we started in 1958. This was the 50-year kind of throwback set to that. And you can see Keldkirk Christensen on the cover of the box there. The Lego packaging is always fun with the kids playing. Large Power Miners sets, another super fun theme. I think the colors are really unique here with kind of that lime green look. That was great as well. The Lego games were always a unusual theme, very different for Lego. But I know it was around for quite a few years. We're in 2009 here. Republic Dropship with AT-OT from 2009 is one very popular Star Wars set, I think still considered a fantastic set today. And then you start to see 2009, some of the Carnival amusement park rides with this Grand Carousel, and it had motorized functions. Larger Bionicle sets here. Look fantastic. Make sure I get that back on the shelf. There we go. and then some of your larger scale Technic stuff as well, which we've gotten so many massive Technic cars and vehicles today. So we are getting into the early 2010s now, and it's like the large tower bridge. So again, what you started with the modulars, and you started to see more of that push into the adult audience. So you start to see the large architectural models, and Rockefeller Center, the White House with the architecture sets. Some of my favorites are those architecture sets. Some fantastic pirates, not as common in the in 2010, but you still get the Imperial flagship, which is a fantastic set that I know a lot of people still enjoy today. Some of the last great castle sets that we had here with the kingdoms. So it's been a while since we had a full-fledged kind of castle theme come out. I love these Prince of Persia sets because they were so unique. This is 2010. I know the movie wasn't real popular, but the sets were really unique and gave us some great pieces. Always more Duplo. This is something that you see kind of throughout many, many decades of LEGO. They're always, revisiting the Duplo idea. They revisit the police stations, the fire stations, the city stuff. Kind of again and again, you start to see that. Some of the other unique stuff here is Pharaoh's Quest, which is a pretty short-lived theme, but had a really fun adventures sort of idea and just lots of really unique pieces if you're into kind of Egyptology and that type of architecture. Over here we go into 2012. You can start to see this packaging had some, you start to get Ninjago sets come out. LEGO Universe being advertised, RIP to LEGO Universe there. But yeah, you start to see Ninjago. Here is the Monster Fighters set, which is just really cool. And again, brings those ghosts back. Great elements there. In 2012, you got the Hayabusa. So this is back when it was LEGO Kuso, before LEGO Ideas. That crowdfunding, also with Minecraft, the Micro World there. Some of those early sets. You also see some of the minifigures coming out here. So see some of these. This is series 7, so some of the early series of minifigures, they have the sealed boxes. Star Wars planets. Large-scale Star Wars stuff. Here's the Year of the Snake, and so you see them pushing into more of kind of the Chinese Asian market. And this is in 2013. We'll round the corner. And I'm sure as we get closer to today, more of this will start to look familiar. You had the large Lone Ranger train. Much more Ninjago, some more city sets. Point out, more modulars. The Parisian restaurant. And the Mini Cooper here. You start to see a lot of Friends stuff as well. So Friends becomes a much bigger theme in 2014. Those around that time, LEGO's really starting to push out a lot more of the Friends sets. Big Star Wars stuff, like Boba Fett's Slave 1 in 2014. Fantastic set. It's a Fusion. So this is when LEGO has done a number of attempts over the years at kind of combining digital and physical play and mixed, results with some of that stuff. So this was Fusion, which was one of those attempts. Over here we go into 2015. You've got the huge shield helicarrier. Some of the highlights from that year and some of these much bigger friend sets as well down here. Chima, so you had that for a few years as well. And of course, kind of trying different stuff with city. So this was one of my kind of favorite city sub-themes is when they were kind of like park ranger type of idea. Large scale Ninjago sets. Ultra Agents, we didn't see the original agents earlier, but this was kind of like revisiting the agents idea. Ultra Agents there. Early LEGO Ideas, the Big Bang Theory. And the birds. And we'll Keep moving through here pretty quickly. You've got the large Disney castle, so a lot of this stuff is fairly recent. Large Ninjago, you had this classic Batcave set. It's more of the architecture sets. It was the Assault on Hoth. I remember when this set came out in 2016, definitely not a fan favorite. There were a lot of negative reactions to this, but you know, you grow over the years and you see how things change. Then we'll go into 2017. You of course see the impact of Lego movies. So this is the Lego Batman movie sets. You got a whole bunch of sets that tied in with that. This is Arkham Asylum. So you're, you can see how they kind of tied that in to all of the movies that they were working on at the time. I love this Women of NASA Ideas set as well. Large Ninjago City, still one of maybe my favorite Lego build experience of all time. Just an incredible set, super fun build, super fun display piece, really incredible set. It's great to see them continuing to work on that line in the future. This is the 40th anniversary of Lego Technic. So we saw some of the early Technic stuff, but this is branded from 1977 to 2017 now. 40th anniversary of Lego Technic. It's great to see when they do kind of a throwback type theme. Ship in the Bottle is really great there as well. Now we're getting into 2018, and you start to see there's Betrayal at Cloud City. So revisiting the Star Wars Cloud City sets. The large supercars, as they're called, with the Bugatti Chiron here. And the motorcycles, Ford Mustang, Lego Movie 2, again tying into those sets, the big Welcome to Apocalypse Berg set, and then fantastic Star Wars Technic stuff. Let's see here. Here's the Overwatch theme, which was fairly short-lived, but really got some fun stuff when it was around. Lego Dots, one of the more experimental Lego themes in recent years. Hidden Side, again, trying to combine that digital and physical play experience. Brought us some unique pieces and minifigs. This is in 2020, so getting pretty close to today. Still in 2020 here, you've got something like the Grand Piano, which is one of the best kind of display pieces Lego has ever done. This box is super heavy, so I'm not even going to pull it down. the massive Colosseum. Down here, again, super cool display piece. One of the coolest boxes and packaging ever is the Lamborghini set from 2020. Looks amazing. And then into 2021, here's the Hogwarts icons. And if you go kind of on the other side of this wall, you can see there's lots more space here. So we've got 2021, 2022, coming into 2023 when we're recording this video now. A lot of these sets are still available today with just kind of your general car models here. You've got like the Fender guitar from my Ideas, the Ferrari car here. So a lot of this stuff is very recognizable still today, and they continue to add all of this to the archive. It's great to see that they have lots of space and continue to update this. And yeah, you can see the years go all the way to 2023. So this is a really nice space. It definitely feels much more open than the old archive did. It's kind of a more pleasant experience walking around here. I know a lot of people always ask us about kind of light and how that affects things. As I said, this is a working archive, so you've got other archives that preserve these sets as well. This is where designers and people can come in and kind of really appreciate all the history of Lego. They also have special windows and things that help, you know, block out some of the UVs and help preserve what is here for as long as possible. Now, at the very back here, you start to see some of the early wooden toys. You can see some of the number years in the early to late 1930s. So this is really cool because Lego started as making wooden toys. So before 1958, when the archive starts with the plastic toys, this is what they were doing, and you start to see the references to kind of the Lego duck model and all of these different animals and playthings here. I love the kind of alligator down there and the truck. So this is really referencing kind of a lot of that early Lego history. As we round the corner, you've got the boat and the fire truck. More trucks and vehicles. These hangars are pretty funny here in the early 1940s. And more fire trucks and trains. 1943. Here in the late 40s, 1949 and early 50s, you were making these like wheelbarrows, kind of shovels, all have that Lego branding. One of my favorite displays here is over here with these rifles they made. This is 1956 and then 1953. So, of course, one of the things that Lego is famously is famous for is kind of their stance on weapons and military builds. So it's interesting to see them making that kind of stuff early on in the years leading up to their plastic toys. You've got some kind of play games there. Here you start to see some actual kind of Lego bricks starting to appear. Again, going back to kind of the early 1950s, you see a lot more of these wooden toys as well. Here's a interesting castle build from 1953. And this is like a whole sort of farmhouse. Tractors down here from 1952. One of the craziest things they've done is actually this gun that I believe was fully operational. This is 1949. You could actually fire little projectiles out of that thing, which is kind of crazy to think about them making that. And then over here on this wall is kind of more into the mid to late 50s. This would be taking you into 1958, kind of right on the cusp of those sets that we saw at the very, very beginning of the archive today. As you walk down, you can see, like, I think this is like a little church model from 1957. Lots of different iconic designs with the red and yellow coloring here. 1954 here. It's like you also kind of have another church there. You can see some of, obviously using some of that architecture from the area. Some of the cars, and then this is a cool sort of like Palisade Fort idea almost from 1953. So that shows you some of the early wooden toys. So they've really kind of done a great job expanding the archive here since they moved it and adding more to the 1958 to today section, and then even bringing out these wooden toys here as well. So this archive is not open to the public, if I didn't mention that, but they have been very generous to let us come in and record here and show you some of the incredible history of Lego over the decades. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this trip through Lego history.